Hello, everybody, and welcome to this special CUBE conversation. I'm Dave Vellante, and we're here with Çetin Özbütün, who's the Executive Vice President for Autonomous AI Database Technologies at Oracle. Çetin, welcome to the CUBE. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you, Dave. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, you bet. Oh, so you guys just wrapped up AI World in Las Vegas. It's pretty awesome. You delivered a keynote, I know, talking about Autonomous AI Lakehouse service. I wasn't there, but I watched the keynotes and I saw a lot of the action, and our team, of course, was there covering the announcements and provided the analysis. Very impressive what you've done with Autonomous AI Lakehouse and just the general direction that you're headed in particular. I mean, Iceberg stood out to us, but Çetin, you know, to get us started, I wonder if you could just give us a high level of the Autonomous AI Lakehouse.
Sure. Autonomous AI Lakehouse is an open, interoperable data platform, and it combines the best performance, reliability, security of Oracle Autonomous AI Database with the openness of Apache Iceberg. By being open, you know, not dependent on any single vendor, customers can discover and access data wherever it is, across data platforms and across clouds. Our goal is to deliver a data platform without compromises, the full functionality of Oracle's database technology with the openness of Apache Iceberg.
Well, okay, open and interoperable, there's a lot in there. Cross clouds is another sort of interesting concept. We just had Juan on recently and we were talking about Oracle's multi-cloud strategy, which we feel is the most comprehensive in the industry. But I want to come back to open and interoperable. That's an alluring message for customers, but it's not something that traditionally people associate with Oracle and Oracle databases. So what would you say to your detractors who would push back on that? How are you delivering openness and why now?
Yeah, sure. Openness actually is not new to Oracle. Like you said, Dave, we just finished our AI World, and many years ago, you know, the name of that conference was Oracle Open World. You know, what set Oracle database apart was that it ran on many different operating systems, providing customers that choice. So in many ways, openness is kind of part of our DNA, but you know, what happened with the cloud is cloud has delivered very big benefits for data management. You know, virtually, you know, unlimited capacity, elastic scalability, very low cost storage, but customers tell us they want more. They don't want their data locked into silos. And Oracle database engine, you know, is arguably the best database engine ever built. But as Iceberg becomes more popular, we want to bring all of those capabilities of the Oracle database to that open ecosystem, because we believe we have unique advantages. You know, Autonomous AI Database is the fully managed version of Oracle AI Database. It eliminates human error and handles, I think, over 48 billion queries per hour. That is the power that, you know, we're making available to Iceberg tables. And very importantly, it runs on every cloud, OCI, AWS, Azure, and Google Cloud.
So interesting. I mean, you say arguably the best. Maybe we could debate that, but I don't think anybody could argue that it's the most successful database of all time. You guys, you know, won that war and still battling for supremacy and doing quite a good job of it. Lakehouse, though, is something that's been around for a while. There are a lot of companies selling lakehouses. How does Oracle differentiate in this crowded body of water where everybody supports Iceberg open table formats?
So first, of course, is Autonomous AI Database. Nobody has a fully autonomous database that leverages AI and ML to fully execute manual tasks such as provisioning, backups, monitoring, application indexing, and more. And it's all powered by Exadata. So that's the starting point. You know, it allows customers to use a single database, you know, optimized for all workloads and data formats. No need to purchase, integrate, manage many specialty databases and deal with these data silos, et cetera. Now you can scale up your databases, scale down according to your actual needs, not via rigid fixed size instances that some of the vendors out there force customers to have. And that's our starting point. right? What we're now delivering is the industry's best support for Iceberg. We're integrating our entire stack with Iceberg, not just great SQL support, you know, but the full functionality of this Oracle database with capabilities like graph and graph analytics, vector search on Iceberg, built-in data integration on Iceberg, all our catalog capabilities optimized for Iceberg.
Yeah, so you guys were, I don't know if you were first, but you were early on in having that granularity versus say the t-shirt sizes, sort of small, medium, and large. So, you know, props for that. When you think about Oracle's traditional strengths and, you know, what I call the wheelhouse, it's obviously you're well known for mission critical, operational and transactional workloads and databases. When I think of Iceberg, sometimes I worry, Chet, and it's like the Wild West, but what's the connection between sort of the traditional, you know, transaction world and mission critical workloads and Iceberg?
Yeah, that's a great question, Dave. Look, Oracle databases store the world's most valuable business data. In fact, 97% of the Fortune 100 run Oracle databases, right? Now, Oracle Autonomous AI Lakehouse is in GA today, but next, what we're doing is we're taking Iceberg to places that other cloud data vendors can't. We're leveraging the technologies built for Autonomous AI Lakehouse to bring Iceberg capabilities to every Oracle database, on-premises or cloud databases, analytic or operational databases. With Oracle, your operational systems can tap directly into your Iceberg Lakehouse because customers want their data and AI available everywhere, not just in analytic platforms.
How, just a side question, how are you able to do that? Is that because you've got the hardware and software integration? Why is it that Oracle is able to bring that open technology to more workloads?
So the secret there is our catalog. So we're making all of our catalog functionality that we built for our AI Lakehouse and making all of that available for on-premises or for all Oracle databases, wherever they are. Right? Every Oracle 26 AI database will have the capability to be able to interact with our catalog. Therefore, whatever Iceberg data our catalog knows about, it will be available to all the Oracle 26 AI databases.
Got it. I have some catalog questions, but before I get there, I saw that Databricks was quoted in your Autonomous AI Lakehouse announcement. And in fact, I'd give them credit. I think they actually sort of started this whole Lakehouse movement. How does this all fit in from a customer perspective?
We're all about being open, and Databricks is one of the platforms that we can integrate with. Our catalog can easily integrate with their catalog. They have a catalog called Unity Catalog, for example, to show all the metadata and data that is living in their lakehouse. So our catalog approach is a catalog of catalogs approach, where you can just come in and point us to a Databricks Unity Catalog, for example, in this particular instance. And we will, from that point on, understand everything that happens to live in that catalog. So that's one of the ways we integrate. This our catalog of catalogs approach enables us to integrate with not just Databricks, but really every popular lakehouse vendor out there.
Yeah, this is something that the industry has, the customers that I talk to have wanted. They want that sort of bi-directional capability. So I want to talk about the state of the sort of lakehouse industry generally, but specifically what your data catalog is aiming to address, because, you know, one of the lakehouse capabilities that really stood out is that catalog of catalogs, Chetin, that you just mentioned, which are very intriguing to me. Tell us more about it. Like, what are the customer benefits? Am I correct that it is bi-directional? I can not just read, I can write to, push updates to other catalogs, and you know, just talk about how you interact with these other catalogs.
Sure, yeah. First, let's look at what we think is going on in the industry. you know, customers have been buying into this idea of moving their data to one or sometimes more data analytics platforms. We have Snowflake, Databricks, Amazon Redshift, Google BigQuery, and others. And once there, you know, they're finding that they've created more data silos. It just now happens to be in the cloud. So it's difficult to, for example, combine, you know, on-premises data with a cloud data platform data, or even more difficult across cloud data platforms. With the Autonomous AI Database Catalog, which, as I mentioned, we refer to as Catalog of Catalogs, it becomes really simple to do that. It provides customers with a unified view of enterprise data across multiple cloud and on-premises data assets. You can easily connect to databases, data lakes, data shares, you know, existing data catalogs from other vendors and platforms such as Databricks Unity, AWS Glue, or Snowflake's Horizon. So our catalog, unlike many other vendors' catalogs, we don't insist on being the main catalog. We just integrate with all the existing popular catalogs out there. So you point us to whatever catalogs you may be using, and from that point on, we're happy to use all the data and metadata in those catalogs that you give, you provide us access for.
Thank you for that. So, you know, we got excited with open table formats and Iceberg. Everybody seems to be, you know, moving at least in part in that direction to hedge their bets and so forth. But we know that Iceberg data sets can sometimes, especially, you know, when they get big, can slow down query performance. I mean, you've got technical challenges. My understanding is that it's, you know, related to the metadata and the file sizes and the way partitioning is managed. So as the number of files and partitions grow, query planning and execution start to get really complex for customers and inefficient. What's your take on that? And can Oracle address this problem? And if so, how does it do that?
Yes, absolutely. So the secret sauce there also is, first of all, Exadata. AI Lakehouse runs on Exadata as its platform. And this is, you know, not just on OCI, as you know, but on all clouds, right? AI Lakehouse runs on Exadata on all clouds. So one of the really cool features of the AI Lakehouse is called Exadata Table Cache, which caches frequently accessed Iceberg data automatically within Exadata flash storage to deliver the performance of native Exadata tables. So you get the performance of Exadata for the price of object storage. Now, that's for kind of repeated query sets across, let's say, if you have, you know, petabytes and petabytes of data living in the object store lakehouse, and you're querying the latest, let's say, weeks or months of data, just as an example, all of that will be automatically cached in Exadata flash cache, and we will provide the flash performance of Exadata for those queries.
Got it. Okay, thank you.
For the kind of queries, we have another cool feature called Data Lake Accelerator, and it automatically allocates additional network and compute resources based on query demand. And when you're going against, again, petabytes of data that may be living in object stores, we can accumulate lots and lots of virtual machines, each of which will run queries on your behalf against the object store data. But customers are only charged for these additional resources while they are being used. So it's a completely pay-per-use model. So it's a great new feature that is part of the AI Lakehouse also. It's called Data Lake Accelerator.
Okay, so you got Exadata Table Cache and then the Data Lake Accelerator, which is dynamic. Of course, it's autonomous. So this happens automatically and it'll scale up and scale down as the workload demands, and I only pay for what I use, correct?
Yes, absolutely right.
All right, got it. You had previously offered Autonomous Data Warehouse, and then before that you had Oracle database, and of course Exadata was well-known data warehouse platform for on-prem. What's the path for customers to move to Autonomous AI Lakehouse? What's the migration path and how complicated is it?
Yeah, first, for customers of Autonomous Data Warehouse, there's nothing to move. Just the very next time they access Autonomous Data Warehouse in the cloud of their choice, they're automatically upgraded to Autonomous AI Lakehouse with no changes on their part at all. No changes to applications, nothing to certify, nothing to test. They keep 100% of existing data warehouse functionality and get all of the new capabilities for Iceberg. Now, for customers who are running Exadata data warehouses in their own data centers, Autonomous AI Lakehouse is a fabulous addition to that. Many of those data warehouses have been around for years or even decades. They're mission-critical analytical systems tightly built into their core business processes. So they aren't very easily movable to a new platform or to a vault cloud. Oracle's support for of Iceberg, though, provides a unique path for modernization there as well. And customers can continue to run their data warehouse applications on premises like that, while incrementally adding kind of new data sets in Iceberg at their own pace. We think it's the right path for many enterprises to take.
So that's how, that would be my modernization pass. I would move the new stuff into Iceberg and then sort of have my traditional workloads as there if I need them, still, like I said, mission critical, I'll still use them, but the incremental new I'll modernize through Iceberg, is that right?
Yes, absolutely. And the key there is, just like you said, it's incremental and at your own pace, right? So there's no switching, big cost that you have to take. You can incrementally start using your Iceberg data sets at your own pace, yes.
It's definitely a theme we're seeing out of AI world is just the simplified migration paths. Can I get AI Lakehouse today? Where and when?
Yes, it's available today on OCI and all the hyperscalers, AWS, Azure, Google Cloud. We, you know, at AI World, we announced that that support that all hyperscalers are now offering Autonomous AI Lakehouse.
Love it. Like I said, most comprehensive multi-cloud strategy in the industry. Chetin, thank you so much. I really appreciate having you on.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dave, for the opportunity. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. And thank you for watching this CUBE conversation. Until next time, this is Dave Vellante.